Hello dear students, myself I am Dr. Sudhir KV from the Department of Psychology. Today we are going to know about the introduction to psychology. Let us see what is psychology. Most of the laymen or the people used to think that psychology is something different. If you say that I am a psychology student, they used to look at you and used to ask you that can you read my mind? So like this, there are lot of questions arise in common people about psychology. But what exactly psychology is the question now. Now let me explain you how psychology originated. Psychology was earlier part of philosophy. It emerged from the philosophy. So here psychology comes from the two important Greek words, psyche and logos. Psyche comes from, the term psychology comes from two Greek words, psyche and logos. Psyche means soul and logos means science or study. So psychology, the meaning of psychology is study of soul. The question comes now, whether we can study a soul? It is not possible, isn't it? So it is not physically observable. It is metaphysical in nature. So this concept of soul, study of soul, was given by Aristotle. Then the people, they discarded this explanation about psychology, and then later the study of mind was the explanation about psychology. What do we mean by study of mind? So we are going to study a person's mind. Is it possible? Here also mind is not observable. It is also metaphysical in nature. So it is not directly observable. That's why this definition also discarded. Next comes the concept of study of consciousness. This was one of the important turn that took place in psychology regarding the explanation of psychology, what exactly it is. William Wundt, in the year 1879, he established a laboratory at Leipzig in Germany, and he defined psychology as the study of consciousness or conscious experiences. It's somewhat near to reality, and to a certain decades of time it was accepted. Later he developed a theory of psychology which is also called a school of psychology, that is structuralism. Next we are going to know about the next definition, that is study of behavior. Later psychology, the studies came across psychological fields so that they rejected the concept that it is the study of consciousness. We study unconscious activities also related to human minds, like sleep activities, our unconscious, many things. So that is why this definition given by Wundt was also discarded. Later the concept of behavior came into light. So here the behavioristic school of thought emerged. They said that each and every behavior that is observable, that can be studied. So that is why psychology is the study of behavior. Of course it is the study of behavior only, because we can study the observable behavior. Then this definition was accepted by many psychologists and many people across the world. They accepted this definition, study of behavior. As the researchers emerged in the field of psychology, they said that of course it is the study of behavior, but still there is something to add to it. that is nothing but it is the study of not only human behavior but also animal behavior. So we not only study the human behavior in psychology, we also study the animal behavior in psychology. That is why it is the study of human and animal behavior. Later, the gradual growth of psychology rejected this definition also. They said that there is something different. We can define psychology in a different way. Later, psychologists defined psychology in a different way. That is, psychology is nothing but later psychologists defined psychology in a different way. That is, psychology is nothing but mental study of mental processes and behavior, or study of behavior and mental processes. That is the now and at present it is accepted as the perfect definition of psychology. You can say that psychology is the study of mental processes and behavior. Next we have to know that what exactly psychology deals with. So psychology deals with many aspects. It deals with the child issues, it deals with the developmental processes, it deals with the biological processes, it studies about our cognitive functions, in the sense our information processing in the brain, it studies about human behavior in the society, it studies about criminal issues, that is also called as forensic issues. So likewise, psychology deals with many issues. Nowadays, there are many branches of psychology emerged across the world as a result of research studies. You can see around 58 of branches in psychology. Going to the next slide, that is schools of psychology. In the process of emergence of psychology, lot of thoughts emerged. So they are called as schools of psychology. There are many different types of schools in psychology which explain what exactly psychology is and what exactly it deals with. Some of the schools of psychology are, one is structuralism. When I was explaining about the definition of consciousness, I said that William Wundt established the psychology laboratory at Leipzig in Germany in the year 1879. So then he developed the theory of structuralism, which was the earliest theory of psychology or school of psychology. It mainly focuses on the consciousness. They study the consciousness. William Wundt said that if you want to study the human psychology, then you have to focus on the elements of consciousness. By studying the elements of consciousness, you can study what exactly happening in the mind of the person and what is his personality is. That we can study. He established the laboratory and he developed many experiments and try to make psychology as a behavioral science. So because of him only, the psychology has become science. So that is why we call him as the father of experimental psychology. So how to study the human mind is the question now. He suggested the method of introspection. Introspection method is the best method to analyze oneself or one's own mind. What is introspection? It is nothing but looking into one's own mind. So one can do the analysis of his mind based on his daily life experiences. That is how one can study his own behavior. But this school of thought was rejected later on because of they cannot study the mind properly, because it becomes subjective and there is no any scientific methods to explain how the human mind works. So that's why it was rejected. The next school comes, that is called functionalism. Let us see what is functionalism in the next. Let us see what is functionalism in the next class. Thank you.